Hey everyone, today we are at Canberra Airport with a visitor. It's Mikey. We have, by the looks of it so far, we have these two airplanes, which are the first one in front of us, a turboprop de Havilland Canada, Dash 8, Qantas Link. The second one is an Embraer Qantas Link, Pacific model E190. And on the other side is it's a Virgin Australia 737, and of course Link Airways Saab 340B+. So yeah, that's the intro basically at this point, and I'll see you guys in a bit. Here we go, here's the first one. Now there's two ways it can go. There we go, there's another one landing. So there's two ways it can go, where it can taxi. So it's either gonna use that turn off or it's actually gonna go past us. So this is my flight, everyone, from Canberra to Sydney in about 3 weeks' time. I'm not sure, but this is definitely the aircraft. And it's gonna go right past us. Two layout actually. That's the rudder. That just helps it turn. So right now using the pedals. You've got one big one coming in fast. Yeah. This one's probably Jetstar. It looks like an A320. Yeah, it is.
Is that the big one?
It's an A320-200. I flew on that last year from Canberra to Melbourne. And their seats are on a 3-3 layout, just like the 737. Touchdown. First thrust, of course. And that's about it for now, and I'll see you guys in a bit. Rightio, so we have a de Havilland Canada coming into land. It's another 400. So, the Saab 340 and the de Havilland Canada Dash 8 series have the same kind of engines, a turboprop. It's nice and sunny out today.
That Virgin one?
No, it's Qantas. Virgin used to operate the ATRs, but they kind of retired them. Yeah. Reverse thrust. And yeah, now we have two. Now it's very rare that you see two of these of the same kind of aircraft here at Canberra Airport. Because the thing is, so most of the time when I'm here, there's only one Q400 here. So the Q400 that you see here, the one we just saw landed and the one that's there, they're Q400s are made by Canadian aircraft. The Canadian aircraft manufacturer that happened in Canada, as you couldn't tell.
I want to know when the big ones take off.
Well, we saw our first big one depart.
So when will they go soon?
Probably.
Have to wait for the others to land a bit. Is that a departing or?
Well, this one here is departing, the one in front of us. Back on that one at any moment now. It's just a matter of time. Here we go. There's the one prop starting. See there?
I see it's spinning.
So they're just gonna. So they're gonna start that pushback pretty soon. There we go. And engine number one is starting now as well. See the way it starts? It's actually known as a gas turbine engine.
Looks like a small one.
So you wait for the pushback to end. So the turboprop is going into high idle now. and they will get pretty noisy at this point. See how they're going at full speed now?
You can hear it, eh?
Now, it's probably not going to end up going past us, unfortunately. It'll take that taxiway there.
Okay.
So it'll turn off before it can even get to us.
Why doesn't it come down this way?
I don't know, man. I suppose it's a, it's actually better if we do this on the weekend. Not gonna lie. So yeah, I'm actually doing this during the week, everyone.
On Monday.
So it's gonna start taxiing any moment now. Here we go. Now you'll see it's gonna turn here. I'm not actually expecting anything. Of course, yes, of course, I'm kind of hoping that it does, but you can kind of see here. However, though, the good news is you get a nice clear view of it. There was one rare occasion, though, where it actually did come past here.
Really? Oh, no.
And I can say I was there to witness it, too. So it's waiting for that plane to take off. There's a lot of cars here, everyone, on the week, so... Of course, here comes Virgin Australia, which either with their 800 or 700, and that's definitely an 800. Oh, there's actually a plane coming into land. I didn't even see that.
It's a Jetstar.
It's not a Jetstar. Is Qantas Link with their McDonnell Douglas MD95. So yeah, they're waiting for that. Thank you. go. She's off. So we all know this is the iconic 737. Here we go. Yeah. The turboprops are mainly louder when they... The turboprops are actually louder than that when they taxi.
That's crazy.
So this plane here that you see is being retired at the end of this year.
Is it?
Yeah. So I'm flying back from Sydney to Canberra on this thing.
Why is it getting retired?
They found it. They found a replacement for it.
Okay.
Which is an Airbus.
Yeah. Okay.
Not the A380, obviously. The one that actually matches its benefits. You know, it's standard, so. Yeah. Another one coming into land.
Is it?
Yeah, it looks like the same kind as this one that's departing right now.
Oh yeah. It's spotting there.
Whatever it is, it's coming in fast.
It is, eh?
Luckily, I can zoom into it to get a good look. Yeah, it's an Embraer. Embraer 190. Nope, that's Virgin Australia. With a rare 700. Now that's a 700, not an 800. it's not much at the moment. I'll see you guys in a bit. Still waiting for that to happen in Canada door to close. Probably not, I don't know. The only planes that don't get pushed back here are the Link Airways. Link Airways are so short, if you could see, they're like much shorter, they're a little bit shorter than the Dash 8, but there we go. Turboprop number 2 is starting. So very soon the other one's going to start as well.
Nice work in the corner.
I'm pretty happy here. And there we go. Oh no, it'll probably do the same thing. Turboprops are getting ready. There's another one coming into land. 717. For that to have in Canada to depart, to take off. So you can see that I know this aircraft too damn well.
Oh, absolutely, man.
So I kind of know the routes they take to the runway. Testing reverse thrust. Make sure that's working. And takeoff will happen any moment now. He has to be waiting. Airways. So that's what I was waiting for. See how it's not that much smaller, but a little bit? Off. Well, that's about it. Hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you guys in the next episode. Bye.